Congratulations on having decided to start your food business. But are you still confused as to what you should be selling? Well, deciding on a menu can be tricky if you're just starting out. I'm sure you have plenty of questions regarding this, saying what kind of cuisine should I sell, what kind of food should I make, how should I price these dishes, how many menu items need to be there, etc., etc. Today, we are going to address all of these questions and much more. The answer is simple. Whatever you are most comfortable cooking with, simplicity is the key. The dishes on your menu could be something that you have grown up eating or something that you have developed an expertise in after years and years of cooking. If you love making laddus and cupcakes for your kids, start with that. Some people start with idli and dosa batter, while some others start with dal, roti, sabzi, etc. If you have an interest in baking, start with a simple chocolate cake. You can always improvise your menu along the way based on your buyer's taste preferences and their feedback. Well, this depends on a number of factors. Are you going to be cooking in a home kitchen or in a commercial kitchen like a cafe or a restaurant, etc.? Do you have helpers or are you cooking by yourself? Are you going to sell perishable items such as a chocolate cake or something that has a longer shelf life like cookies? Even the kind of equipment that you are using in your kitchen matters. All of these factors that I just spoke about will help you determine how many dishes to put on your menu. The truth is, there is no optimum number of dishes that you can have. You can have either 5 or 50 depending on the factors that I just spoke about. The first thing is dish trials. Always ensure that there is a balance of flavors in your dish, whatever it is that you're making. Practice. Practice till you succeed in getting the right taste. The second thing is the portion size. The portion size is the amount of food that you are serving to your buyers in one serving or one plate. Please always ensure that the quantity of food you are serving is more than enough for one person. Your buyers should not go hungry after eating your food. If you are selling fulkas with some sabzi, make sure to add 4 fulkas instead of 2 to 3. Even though you may prefer to eat only 1 to 2 fulkas, your customers may prefer 4. So be generous with your portion sizes. Another important factor is feedback. Constantly ask your family, friends, and your neighbors to taste your dishes and to give you their feedback. Getting feedback can really help you understand what your buyers may like and what you can include in your menu. And it can also help you in improving your cooking skills. Once you've decided the menu items, you can easily create a menu with Chef Buddy app's menu designs and even share it with your buyers on WhatsApp or on social media platforms. Chef Buddy has lots of free menu designs for every festival, and there are some dish-specific designs as well, such as dips, pickles, desserts, Indian food, etc. The great thing about these menus is that all of these menus go with a quick order link to your buyers. All your buyers have to do is click on the link to place their orders. You can go to the Your Menu section on the Chef Buddy app and start creating your menus. I hope you found this video useful and the tips I shared will help you decide what your first few menu items need to be for your food business.